Good morning, children. I hope you are enjoying the lectures on IUPAC nomenclature of organic compounds, because this is something which you have learned once, you needn't revise again and again. It's, you know, it goes inside. It means you will be able to name it as soon as you are able to see the structure. Now, till now we have considered single functional groups and all individual functional groups, and all the rules I have given in my previous videos. Now we are going to apply them on certain examples and then try to name them. Now, suppose this is the example given to you. What is the first rule we discuss? That we have to select the chain. So we will select the chain. Don't make a mistake of always going for the straight chain. You can even select this chain. The chain, remember I told you, can go in any direction, but it has to be the longest continuous chain. So this is our chain. Numbering, second rule. So you can number from either side. The side chains are getting the same position. So we will number it 1, 2, 3. Now what order, children, I've told you, you need to first name prefix. So what is the prefix? Methyl. So word root, we will write after that. It is 2 position methyl. At 2 position, there is methyl present. This is the functional group. This has to be named later. After the prefix, what are we supposed to write? Word root. And the word root for 3 carbon is pro. All single bonds in the selected chain, ane. E has to be deleted. And 2 position, there is all also. So the name becomes 2 all. Right? Now, the next one. You first identify what is the functional group present in this. Now, if you see, it is COOR. The functional group is ester. How we name ester? I told you the part that is with O will be alkyl and the remaining part is the word root. And the remaining carbon atoms, you will select the chain such that the double bond is also included in the chain. Obviously, this carbon you will not be selecting. Why? Because these are not linked directly. This is COOR. So this will be our main chain, right? And now this part has to be named first. So what is this part you have to name first? Methyl. Methyl. Right. And then what is the main word root here? The main word root is pro. But on that pro, on 2 position, there is methyl. Because this you are going to number like this from the side that is attached to COOR. So at 2 position, now again methyl is there. Okay. So we will write down the name as methyl. This methyl is for this. And now 2 position, you'll put a comma here, and 2 methyl, this is now for this methyl. And then what is the word root? Pro. And then you have ene also, 2 position ene. So you will write down pro 2 ene. And how do you name esters? Alkanoate. This is alenoate. So you will write down the name as ene, and then 1 position there is O8. Oh, wait, got it? So this is the complete name: methyl, 2-methyl, prop, 2-ene, 1-8. Now let's take the next one. Identify the functional group, ketone. Select the chain, 1-7 lengthwise. But this, there is a double bond also. In case there is a double bond, you have to ignore the longer chain also. So you will select this chain. This will be your chain. And if the functional group is present, you need to give preference to the functional group. You will ignore double bond also, because whatever things are present, accordingly you need to give the preference. So it has to be numbered from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Even though 7 carbon atom was present, we will neglect that. Now what all side chains are there? At 3 position there is methyl, and 4 position there is propyl. So what is the substituents, the radicals? You will name them in the alphabetical order. So you will write down 3 methyl, and then you have at 4 position N propyl. It is 4 N propyl, normal propyl. Instead of writing, you know, N propyl, you may just write propyl also. Okay. So it is propyl, this is the, you know, all the prefixes over, word root is hex, right? and double bond is there at fifth position. Between 5 and 6 means we will write down 5 position. Hex, 5, ene, and then 2 position there is one. So 2, one. This is the complete name. Clear? Now, let's take the next example. Select the chain, 5 carbon atom. No, if we select this, we are ignoring functional group. You cannot ignore it. You have to include this in the main chain. You have to include this as the chain. So numbering from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You could have gone this way also. That is not a problem. Prefix is ethyl. So what is the name? 2. Prefix is ethyl. Then the word root is bute. All single bonds ane. And one position, oic acid. Butane, I'm just continuing down. Oic acid. Right, butanoic acid. Clear till here? You can take down the structures, pause it in between, and try naming them on your own also. Now, there is ether, but ether is always named the prefix. It is not the example of two functional groups. So we will consider this one as the main, that is ketone. So you will have this as the main chain. Now, numbering from left to right. Total 5 carbon atoms are there. From left side, if I number, this is ethoxy. 2 carbon alkoxy, no? Ethoxy. This side, methoxy. So, if I number from here, ethoxy gets 2. If I number from right, methoxy gets 2. Give preference in the alphabetical order. So, you will write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, what is it? 2 position, ethoxy, 2 ethoxy. Then you put a comma here, 4 methoxy. This is all prefix over. Now, what is the word root? Pent. All single bonds, pentane. 3 position, on, pentane, 3, on. This is the name. Clear? Now, the next one. You can see if we select this chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is no other possibility of selecting any chain. So, 1, 3, 4, 5. And then this will be the prefix. There is only one prefix. It is 2 position, chloro. And the word root is for 5 carbon atom, pent. And then the primary suffix is ine, 3 position, ine. And then one position you have, al. Clear? Okay. So quickly we will name them. I'm just going this way. I think you can try naming them on your own. Then I will write down the name so that you save time. If you have written the names, now you can check it. 2 carbon atoms, ethane, single bond, 1, 2, dioic acid. 2 acids were there. Okay. Then this is children repeated. So this you can cancel out. This one. There is amide functional group, CONH. And then there is chlorine also, chloro, halo group. So now how you are naming it? How we name them otherwise, alkanamide. But before that, on N, there is ethyl also present. Plus on 3 position, there is chloro and 3 position methyl. So you will name them as 3 chloro. On N position, there is ethyl. Alphabetical order, I have placed all the prefixes. See, chloro, then ethyl, then 3 position methyl, then alkane, word root is pent, ane, 1 amide. Got it? The next one, there is, CN. How do you name cyanides? Alkane nitrile. But ane, if it is ane, it is ene now. So this is the prefix. First you select the chain, number it. Prefix is 3 position methyl, pent, 3 position ene. This is the prefix, word root. Primary suffix, secondary suffix. Clear? If you follow the rule, you will never go wrong in the nomenclature. But only thing is, you cannot ignore the rules, right? Now, as I said in my previous video, they can be also given in the bond line notation. You can have like this also. This means it is CHO here, aldehyde. So, I have selected the chain such that the double bond is also included and keeping in mind the longest chain. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, prefixes, there are 2 prefixes. 2 position ethyl, 3 position methyl. I have put them in the alphabetical order. Word root is pent. Double bond at 2 position and 1 position al. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can please put it in the comment section, right? So one more is there of this type. We'll number it first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's also Bonline notation. The prefixes are 3 position, there is 2 methyl, and 5 position, there is 1 more. So we will write down as 3, 3, 5. All 3 are same, so we can combine them. Tri, methyl, and the word root is hex. And then you have hex, 1 position you have ene, so hex 1-ene, and 2 position you have ol. So this is the name, right? Now so far whatever examples I have considered, they were having only one functional group. So now we will be taking example where, you know, there are 2 functional groups. But if 2 functional groups are there, the nomenclature also changes. So what does the nomenclature become? That I will tell you first. Just note down this in your copies. In case there are 2 functional groups, what the name becomes? See, this already halo that we have done. If it is OH, till now we were naming this as ol. If it is a secondary functional group, then its name becomes hydroxy. This we do not have many such examples. Even this we don't consider much because ether always you name as alkoxy. NH2, otherwise NH2 you are naming as amine. If it is a secondary functional group, secondary means if 2 functional groups are there, one is primary, that is more important one, and the second one is secondary. So if this is secondary, it will be named as amino. NHR means one H is replaced by alkyl group, it will be alkyl amino. If both the hydrogens are replaced by alkyl, it becomes dialkyl amino. CHO otherwise is named as al. Now if it is a secondary functional group, we will name this as formyl. This will be named as formyl. CO, ketone. Ketone otherwise is named as one, but now it will be named as keto if it is a secondary functional group. Then acid, if it is a secondary functional group. In certain cases it can be, but you don't have many such examples again. But otherwise you can note down carboxy. COOR, ester. If it is a secondary functional group, it will be named as alkoxy carbomyl or carb alkoxy. The order which is primary secondary I will be giving you just now. COCl, acid halide. Now it will be named as chlorocarbonyl. Chlorocarbonyl. Clear? Then CN, otherwise named as alkane nitrile. Now, if it is a secondary functional group, it will be named as cyano. COMNH2, otherwise named as alkane amide. Now, if it is a secondary, it will be named as carb amoyl. Okay, so please make this tabular column in your notes copy first, and then I will be telling you if 2 functional groups are there or more than 2 are there, then what should be their order of preference. See children, this is the order. Carboxylic acid, most important. Then anhydride, I hope you know the, you know, functional groups we have discussed that already. Acid, COOH. Anhydride, it is CO, then O, CO, between 2 acids, you know, water was removed. Ester is COOR. Acid halide, COX. Acid amide, CONH2. Then you have nitrile, CN, isocyanide, NC, aldehyde, CHO, ketone, CO, alcohols, OH, phenols. Phenols, of course, we haven't done, but it's aromatic, all aryl alcohol. Amine, NH2, and then double bond, triple bond, and alkyl. These are certain things which I have written down. They are always named in the prefix, so that we do not consider in the, you know, primary or secondary. So if 2 functional groups are there, with this is primary, so this is most, suppose there is, you know, alcohol and ketone present, which is more important, ketone, then in that case alcohol will go in the prefix, alcohol will no longer be named in the suffix. So for that, you know, we will take some examples so that it is clear to you. Let's take the examples and start naming them quickly. Now the word root, first we'll select the chain and that will decide the word root. 2 functional groups are there, aldehyde and ketone. out of the two, just now we have seen the order, which is more important? Which is more important? Aldehyde. So this will be the secondary. So you will number like this, 1, 2, 3. Anyhow, you have to number like this only because ketone is never at the end. Aldehyde is always a terminal function group. So now ketone will be named in the prefix. What is the name for ketone in the prefix? Keto or oxo. So we'll write down 2, oxo. Yeah, keto also you can write. Word root is prop, single bonds ane, and one position. Alright, so everything remains the same. Only thing is the name of the secondary functional group goes in the prefix. Clear? Now, there are two functional groups, acid and alcohol. According to the order which I told you just now, acid is more important. Normally, the terminal ones, the ones which are there at the end, that is all acid derivatives, CN, NC, aldehyde, these are all terminal ones. They are always present at the end. They are always important. Okay, but other than that, ketone, alcohol, amine and all, you have to remember the order. So, we will name them, number them, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will now not be named as all, it will be named as hydroxy. OH is named as hydroxy. Three position, there is hydroxy present, alcohol group present, which is now as a prefix named as hydroxy. What is the word root? Bute, single bonds ane, and one position oic acid. Got it? It is not difficult, but if you have followed the individual functional group nomenclature thoroughly, you will never go wrong in the naming. Follow the rule, you will be always right. Now, there is CN and this. As I told you, this is terminal always because three bonds are already covered here. So only one more bond means it will be terminal. So you will number them like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These two are the prefixes, hydroxy and methyl. Let it be functional group or alkyl radical. They will be always named in the prefix in the alphabetical order. So it is 3, you have hydroxy. 3 position, there is OH group which is now named as hydroxy. 4 position, there is methyl. 4 position, methyl, and the word root is pent. And then 4 position, you have ene also. 4 position, ene. And then you will write down ene complete and then nitrile. One nitrile. 4 ene nitrile. Got it? Now, let us name the next one. There are two functional groups. Acid and amide functional group. Which is more important? Acid is more important. So, you will select the chain first. The chain is 3 carbon atom. Right? And then you know that this will be the chain. Numbering will be 1, 2, 3, 4. This whole thing is numbered as carbamoyl now because this is the main functional group. Amide is the next functional group after acid. So acid is primary, amide is secondary. So do not think that this will be your selected chain. No, this will be your chain and this as such will be named as carbamoyl. What position carbamoyl? 2 position. So you will write down as 2 carbamoyl, yes, it's A-M-O-Y-L, carbamoyl, 2 position, word root is prop and single bonds, then you have 1 position oic acid, otherwise you can just write propanoic acid, that is also fine, clear? Right, let's continue further. Yeah, let me take 3 more examples. It will be sufficient, I think, for you to revise now. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon atoms are there. You will number them like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These two will be in the prefix. Then what you have here is that 3 position there is hydroxy. It is 3. Hydroxy, you are putting them in the alphabetical order. Then you have 4 position methyl, that is the prefix. Prefix part is done. After prefix, what do you write? Word root. The word root is pent. Then you have 4 position ene. 4 ene you will have and 1 position al. So this is my prefix. This is the word root. This is the primary suffix. This is the secondary suffix. Right? Now, this one. We will say this is the main chain. Now, what is to be given preference? The functional group is chlorine and then you have double bond also. You might think this is the functional group, this has to be given preference. No, you have to give preference to the double bond. You have to give the preference to the double bond because this is always named in the prefix. If you check, how is Cl named? Chloro, chloroalkane. So this will be always named in the prefix. So what is the name? 3-chloro, 3-chloro, prefix is done, word root prop. And then you have a double bond at one position. Always the lower number has to be written. You might think it is there between 1 and 2, but always you will write down the lower number. You may omit that one also. You may simply write propene. That is understood that it is present at the one position if you are not writing. Now the next one. There are 3 OH groups present. Of course you will be, you know, putting the positions like this. There is no prefix in this. All these are the, you know, present on the main carbon atoms. So the word root is prop, all single bonds, propane. Then you have, you know, 1, 2, 3 triol. 3 position, 3 OH groups are there in the chain. Okay, see, the nomenclature is, you know, endless. If you go for many, many examples, you will get some, many more doubts. You can come forward with your doubts. We will be discussing them. But till then, please practice whatever I have discussed in my this video and the previous videos. And please stay tuned for some more interesting lectures on organic chemistry. Thanks for watching.